Alright, I'm back. Cool. Switch back here. I don't want to keep working on this scene.
I ran out of ideas, really. For sure. So let's try something else for a bit. See if maybe we can get that going.
What
time is it? 1:20. I'll probably go to about 2 o'clock. I might call the stream early. I need to sort of reevaluate the story a bit. I think it's good. it works. I just need to figure out what I actually need to write to make it finished. Dramatic questions I need to answer. Well, maybe what I should do maybe I should figure out kind of like my log line, like what's my summary, what am I trying to do, give like a one paragraph summary, like get the nitty gritty of the story down. And for anybody new tuning in, a log line is a one sentence a one sentence summary of what a story is. It's generally used in film, but I find it extremely useful in a variety of genres and mediums. It comes in handy all the time. What am I trying to say? That makes a lot of sense. Do some more breakdown stuff. too.
Change my mind from what I have here. I think scene two will be take the deal.
So this would be magical addiction. Scene two will be take the deal. So it'd be part so it'd be Earth. So in I guess here's a question that I have. In so this character, his name is Gary on Earth. In the planes, his name is Kevin, and his job as boss refers to him as Perkins, but he also implies that no one knows that he's Gary. So his identity should be different, right? Like he should have a third identity that he's now assumed. Something like that. What else was I thinking? Scene three. Think scene three should be crafting. Because this would be like a weird. Because I want this to parallel him running away on Earth.
think scene four should be Gary's apartment. That was a hell of a pop. Scene five. I think around this time is when we need to really introduce Margot. Right here. So there should be a scene with Margot, I think. Scene five should be Margot. What should scene six be then? The seer? Gary on the run? I think Gary on the run. Visits the seer. He needs to find his magic. Or something similar. So he can once again avoid the cops. I guess. His motivation for seeing the seer is rather unclear, isn't it? Add some
questions. Questions I think need answers. Why does Gary visit this year? What's the status? His search for mercy. What forces him into action? Right at this moment. Yeah, like these are the questions I'm trying to answer, and it's unclear to me at the moment, which is why it's why the typing is slow. But it is what it is. I mean, that's all part of the writing process, right? You gotta try things, you gotta do things, you gotta reevaluate, you gotta rewrite, you gotta edit, rethink. Put something down, come back to it. There's all kinds of stuff. That's part of if what we do. So I guess I go down here. Yeah, this scene will probably be Margot's goals. Scene 5. I don't have anything written there. I'm not sure what the scene is about, other than it's about Margot and it's our introduction to her as a character. Which means that it's on Earth, right? Yeah. Well, I guess it's not the first time she's in the story. It's just the first time she, like, it's the first really revelation, the first reveal of her character, other than that first scene where she kind of just breaks in, right? So what is her goal? What is she trying to do? Why did she come to Earth? I haven't figured that out yet. I know it has something to do with her job. I know it has something to do with Kevin. I'm just not sure exactly where that comes into play. Scene 7. Gary's apartment, Margot's goals, Gary on the run. Hmm.
think this should be leaving. Marcy both hates and loves him. Actually, I'm gonna add slash present. I think these should be the same scene. She finds the gift. He leaves. He made for her. And she's devastated, I guess. Page of questions. Lots of questions. That page out. I'm gonna write down these two questions though. Mysterious emails. We don't have a clear antagonist in this yet either, which is interesting. I kind of set it up so, I mean, Margot is the first antagonist, but is she the main antagonist throughout the entire story? What was I writing? Is Margot always the primary antagonist? If not, who is? Right. What is Kevin? And Marcy's relationship. Before he leaves. And what else do we got? Why does Kevin leave? I have a strong feeling that Kevin knows magic in the plane.
Marcy does not. So she learns it once she gets to Earth. I think that makes the most sense. Scene 8. What the? I just created a new thing. Kevin's mission, Kevin's love, confrontation, and Marcy leaves. Well, I think that this scene should be. This should be a confrontation. And I think this should be Marcy leaves. Confrontation 2, I think, would be this one. Scene 11 will be Kevin's love. This one would probably be finale. I think 12 scenes would do finale, tying up loose ends. Confrontation 2 will be Earth. Kevin's love will be plane. And finale will be Earth, I think. The interesting thing to note is that, other than the prologue, which I don't think counts, there's only this part here, scene 5, that isn't an alternating between Earth and the plane. So it's possible that I need a scene 4B. I'm gonna have to start making a binder for this project. I think I need a scene 4B, which takes place on the plane. And I need a scene 5B, which again takes place on the plane. I mean, there is the unused Kevin's mission, which might work for one of these. If that's the case, then I mean, maybe this would be a good one for like a before their relationship. Maybe do something with that. I think that would work really well. City is SO7. Kevin's mission is SO4B. open. Confrontation one is S08. Marcy leaves is S09. Confrontation two, so S10. I feel like I'm missing something. Those goals. And run, we're gonna save the present. Competition two. Not sure. Oh well. S12 finale slash time. I'm just gonna say finale, that's fine. And then this one, S05B, before their release. Cool. I think we're good. I think that's the scenes I want. I think let's open up my accounts here. I think 20,000 is a little high. I think this is more like 10,000, maybe. Yeah, that's probably more accurate. More in the novel, more in the novelette range. I think that's more accurate with what I'm trying to do. Okay. Cool. Alright. So, cool. So yeah, I think that's gonna be it for me for today. I'm feeling kinda tired. Anyway, I have some stuff to do, so I'm gonna go do that. But yeah, today was okay. I mean, it started off a little slow, but I think the breakdown I made of the scenes and what I'm looking for is pretty good. Though I still do have to detail out a lot of the intricacies and the way that it all works together. I think we're starting to answer some of the questions I've laid out, and I'm going to keep adding to those as we go through the story, because there's lots of them. And, you know, that's just the way the writing process is, right? So I'm going to make a binder for this project so I can have a nice organized binder with all this stuff in it. So I will do that as well. Anything else I wanted to mention? No. So next week I'm going back to one stream a week. It'll be Sundays, 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're going to either work on this project or we're going to work on Fear the Siren issue number 3. One of the two, just because I want to keep moving forward with projects rather than keep starting new ones. Though if you do have any suggestions or want me to do like an episode on a specific thing or try something, please don't hesitate to let me know. My contact info is on the website below, accidentalorigin.com, where you can find all my VODs and additional resources for every episode, as well as like files and stuff like I always upload. The stuff that I worked on for each episode. So I'm going to be exporting what I have right now in terms of the text and log lines and all that, and that will be available on the website. What else? I mean, I might even scan these sheets too. I do that from time to time. I've been doing a lot of writing on them, so maybe I will. Yeah. I needed priority number one for the story is I need a working title for it. So maybe I should do that real quick and then close up. Okay. Yeah. Need a working title for this. What do I want to call it? Maybe Before the Magic Ended? That might be cool. Yeah, we're gonna go with that. So, project. Just updating the project file with that, so it's there. Cool. That works for me. All right. So, yeah, we're going to use that as our working title for the moment. So that's everything. I know I've been saying this a lot, but I am really excited and I'm trying to get the word out. But me and my good friend Sam, MC Pepper Pockets himself, are starting a new show on Axiom Origin called Rewrite, which will be a bi-weekly podcast of a book club. The first book we're going to be reading is The Last Wish by Andrei Sapkowski. And our good friend Martin will be joining us as a guest host. So we're going to be doing two episodes of that book, and then we're going to move on to something else, which will be announced kind of in the first episode and all that. It's nice to have a new show. I'm very excited for it. It's also nice because Sam is doing a lot of the lead stuff for it. So I don't have to worry about, I don't have to invest more time in doing that. He's handling a lot of that stuff so that I can, you know, focus on this and then show up for that and do that. And it'll just be a fun time for me. So I'm very much looking forward to it. Plus, I love talking about writing and books and stories in general, you know, if you couldn't tell. But yeah, so that's going to be it for me for this week. Check out my stuff. My contact info is on the website, VODs, all that stuff. I will be back next week on Sunday for the next episode of Abstinent Origin. I think that's it. I think that's everything. So without further ado, my name is Brendan. This is Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show. Really enjoying this new mic. Thanks for hanging out with me, guys. I really appreciate it. I will see you all next week.